By law, the minimum height of the lowest live wire on an electric walltop fence must be at least 1.5 meters or higher for it to be legal. The walltop brackets are fixed to the wall and should be spaced on average no further than 3 meters apart. On a corner or straining post, a stay pole is required to support the bracket under the tension from the pulling wires. A walltop fence should be tensioned in straight lines with a maximum tension distance of 30 meters. There are various types of tensioners used to maintain the tension between the straining points. The choice of tensioner will be selected based on wire type, wire thickness, tension requirements, and environmental conditions. The wire can be manufactured in stainless steel, aluminium, or galvanized steel, and can be supplied as a solid single core or in braided form in 1.2 and 1.6 millimeter thicknesses. By law, a warning sign has to be placed at 10 meter intervals along the fence and at any access point or location where people will come into contact with the fence. We can add an earth loop that will help prevent the wires from being separated. If the live wire touches an earth loop, the voltage will drop, triggering an alarm. We have a variety of types of earth loops, from single ring types to bipolar tamper resistant earth loops to actual tamper switches, which can be installed on the fence line. To help us monitor the fence, we add an LED fence light between the live and neutral wires. This will give us an indication of power on the fence. Every time the fence pulses, the light flashes. This should be installed close to the house, or energizer, so that the fence owner can monitor it and ensure power is on the fence. One of the most important elements of an electric fence is proper earthing. A minimum of 3 earth stakes should be inserted into preferably moist soil, no less than 1.2 meters deep and spaced a minimum of 1.2 meters apart. By law, an additional earth stake needs to be inserted and connected to the fence every 30 meters in an urban environment or 100 meters on a rural or freestanding fence. The earth stakes are connected to the energizer using double insulated undergate cable, clamped securely in place. We then continue the undergate to the neutral earth return wires on the fence. The live wire runs from the energizer to the fence. The undergate wire needs to be buried at least 30 centimeters deep, or 50 centimeters if it's running under a road, to prevent damage or exposure to the cable. All the undergate wires are to be run through protective conduit piping. The conduit needs to be sealed at the top by the wall to prevent water and dirt from getting into the protective piping and deteriorating the wires. Also make sure to use conduit on all the intermediate earthing wires down the fence as well. To protect the energizer from an electrical surge caused by a lightning strike on the fence, we put a lightning diverter at the energizer. If there is a strike on the fence, the current coming back on the live line will be redirected to the earth stakes before it can reach the energizer, reducing damage. From the auxiliary outputs on the energizer, we can add a warning flashing light that will provide a visual warning that the fence has gone into alarm. This should be placed near the entrance to the property, as in a gate, so that the fence owner can be given an early warning if returning home that something may have faulted on the fence while away. We can have a siren output that will provide an audio alert for the fence owner, and it is also a deterrent to criminals, scaring them away. The siren will time out after a set period. To control the system, we have a keypad that gives us personal, secure access to control the energizer. The four-line LCD will give the owner detailed fence information, such as feed and return voltages, plus maintain a log of alarms and activations for historical support. A JVA Z-Range GSM or a Wi-Fi gateway can be added to give the fence owner control over their fence from anywhere in the world. Notifications are sent to their cellular device, and it allows them the ability to respond accordingly. It is important to remember when wiring systems to keep all low voltage wires at least 20 centimeters away from high voltage wires, unless it's only for a distance of less than 200 millimeters. High voltage has a potential to interfere with 12 volt systems if it is too close. A correctly installed electric fence using JVA's quality range of security products will give you peace of mind security 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, year on year. For more information, please visit our website or connect with us on social media.